Hi everyone, I'm Shalaka Pawar and you are watching the True Gourmand. And in today's episode, I'm going to make Desi Ghee ke instant pedhe. And for this, I'm going to use Desi Ghee by Farmers Fresh. It's A2 Desi Ghee and the best part is that one, it's made with traditional process and two, it's completely untouched by any human hands. And it's pure Desi Ghee. I mean, we all know the real health benefits of pure Desi Ghee. So that's what's gonna go in my instant pedhas along with this skimmed milk powder by Farmers Fresh. These two are our hero ingredients and then we are gonna add a little more things to this pedha to make it taste even better. So let's get started with our Desi Ghee ke instant pedhe. Now to start with this, I'm gonna use 1.5 tablespoon of this Desi Ghee. So this is 1 tablespoon and 1/2 a tablespoon more. Here you go. And now in this ghee, I'm going to add in some milk. So the ghee is anyway melting. I'm adding 1/4 cup of milk. Now the next step is to take a whisk and just mix this milk and ghee here like this. And in this mixture of milk and ghee, I'm going to add in 1 cup of milk powder, but don't add it all together. Add it in batches and then keep on mixing with the whisk so that the milk powder does not form any lumps. So I'm going to put in a little bit at a time, like so, and keep on whisking it. Make sure that you are doing all of this on really low flame, otherwise the milk powder can burn. Now once this changes color a little bit, becomes a little bit yellowish, I'm going to add in 1/4 cup of sugar to this. And now the sugar will also start melting a bit and mixing it really well with our mixture. So just mix this carefully, again on low flame and without burning the milk powder. Now look how nice and golden brown this has become. It's also become a little crystally. So this is the right stage. At this stage I've switched off the gas because we don't want to cook it more. While it is warm, I'm going to add in some flavoring. So I'm going to add in, say, 1/2 a teaspoon of cardamom powder. That's elaichi powder. We love this flavor. And then very little, almost a little less than 1/4 teaspoon. We don't want too much of it, of nutmeg powder. If you have fresh nutmeg, you can just, you know, just grate a little bit of nutmeg at this stage and mix this well. And we just gotta let this cool for a bit so that later we can grind this into a nice, nice fine powder in our mixer grinder. After grinding this in the mixer grinder, I just added it back to the pan and this is how it looks like. If you feel that this is still on the drier side and you can't make pedhas out of it, like you can't put this and pinch it together, in this case, just keep on adding like 1/4 teaspoon of ghee on it, say 1/4 or 1/2 a teaspoon, till you can see a nice lumpy mixture which you can use to make pedha. Make sure you're doing this on a very, very low flame. Now I have cooked this only for 2 to 3 minutes max because the second time cooking should not be a lot, otherwise your pedha will become hard. And it took me around 2 to 2.5 teaspoons of ghee to get to this consistency where I know I can now form some good pedhas. So now I'm gonna just take this out in a bowl. Now once you take this out in a bowl, just apply some ghee on your hands like this, and then with these ghee hands just take a little small bite size morsel and make a pedha out of this. Here you go, one pedha is done. I'm going to keep this aside on a plate and start making the rest of the pedhas. And my friends, these are absolutely ready to eat. Hope you like this recipe as much as I do. If you want to buy the A2 ghee and the milk powder that I spoke about, I'm going to give you links from where you can buy this ghee and milk powder. Do try this recipe at home and let me know in the comment section how it was. I'll see you guys in the next episode of True Gourmand. Till then, bye-bye.